You go and see what happens next.
So I'll start up.
Thank you.
The Ernest Kemp was launched and sailed to the Bay of Islands to repeat what the settler had been doing there some 60 to 70 years earlier, and it operated from the steps of a stone store in the Kerikeri River, right opposite from Kemp House. Everything went well.
Fourth mine bay, because there was a gold mine excavated here many years ago. No gold was found. The rock carvings are up in the right hand corner of this bay, just behind the kets there, and we'll be there shortly. We'll spend a few minutes there, so there's still time to get the photograph and have a good look. And when we do arrive opposite, I'll circle around several times so that they'll be equally visible from all parts of the boat.
Houses on the property then, and it was
private property, so there's a lock gate for security. The main reason for coming here to do the carvings was the rock face with tattoo faces. I've never seen another like that anywhere around.
Tattoo face there on the cliff is a depiction of Ngātora Irangi. Ngātora Irangi was a priest who came to New Zealand from Polynesia aboard the Arawa canoe. Same canoe that brought here the discoverer of the lake, although they traveled inland different groups. Don't worry about Jason. People and would bring the volcanism to the area. And that story goes that he climbed the central mountain and feeling cold there, he used his magical powers called to assist him in Hawaiki to send quite a warm him. And they sent an underground to White Island in Rotorua. And to show his gratitude, he sacrificed a slave named Arawoi by throwing him into one of the steaming holes that opened up in the ground. And that became now Arawoi.
근데 오래 한 사람은요?
세 하는 거 같아요. 세 하는 거 같아요.